Alright, hello everybody, and welcome to another edition of Bill Chasing the Movies this week. I got six new ones to review for you, and we're going to start off at the bottom of the barrel with The Bounty Hunter. Yeah, this is Jennifer Aniston in another romantic comedy. Mm-hmm. And joining her is another romantic comedy alum, Gerard Butler. Mm-hmm. Anyway, where do I begin? This movie just sucked, bottom line. I mean, again, here's a rule that Roger Ebert once said, and I live by this. A golf cart gag is only funny in a film like Caddyshack. And I can't even remember if Caddyshack even had one. Just like he can. And you got Jennifer Aniston, who is likable enough. You got Gerard Butler, who's been very good even in bad movies. But here, there's nothing. There's absolutely nothing. I will say for them that they do have more chemistry than Jennifer Aniston did with Aaron Eckhart in Love Happens. But that's like saying the napkins are good at a bad restaurant. I mean, it's... I said that wrong. Anyway, the point of the matter is that this film just seems to drone up the same cliches that every movie that she has ever done has done. They just try to make it look edgier by making it about a bounty hunter, chasing, action stuff. It's still a romance film. You know that they're going to be together. You know that they have that kind of chemistry, yada yada, and that... Oh, you crazy kids, why don't you just get rid of that whole tension thing and just get together because you belong together. Makes you wonder why they broke up in the first place kind of thing. Basically the whole premise here is this. Gerard Butler is an ex-disgraced cop who's now a bounty hunter who's got to capture his ex-wife who's in the midst of this big story because she failed to appear at court because she's covering this big story. It turns into this whole big thing, nothing funny happens, we got cliched bad guys. Dumb dialogue, including double entendres that would be funny to a 13-year-old. It's just, this movie is just completely and utterly pointless and a waste of time. I mean, how many more of these am I going to have to sit through? I mean, seriously, I mean, the handcuffs were a resounding theme in this movie. I felt handcuffs were needed to keep me in the theater chair. If I wasn't a critic, I would have laughed long before this movie ended. Fact of the matter is that, basically, if I was handcuffed to the chair, I would have chewed my arm off and sacrificed the rest of my life without a right hand. That's how much I hated this movie. I mean, I know they're capable of more. Jennifer Aniston's got more movies coming out soon. I know Gerard Butler's got a big career ahead of him. I mean, here's a guy who was great in films like 300, and even in The Ugly Truth, which wasn't a good movie itself, it wasn't as terrible as this. He's got the energy. Use it to something positive. Why can't some of these actors just know that? Jennifer Aniston's career is going to end by the time she's 45 years old, and she's 40 now. Get moving, Jen, is all I gotta say. You are very charming on Friends, but that's about as far as it goes for you. The Bounty Hunter gets half a star out of 5.